Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on today's show, we'll take a look at the latest tool updates for administering Office 365, including the new simplified portal design and upcoming reporting capabilities, updates to Office 365 admin app for phones, and our new PowerShell site for top tasks, as well as sample scripts for automation. So I'm joined today by Lawrence Chiu. Welcome.
Thank you.
So what's new for Office 365 admins?
So there's a lot of new and exciting enhancements coming to the tools for managing Office 365. First, let's take a look at where we came from.
Okay.
So this is the current admin center. And as you can see, we added more capability. As we added more capability, it became more difficult for some admins to find the common tasks and scenarios. This is especially noticeable on the left nav, where we continue to add more features and functionality.
Right, so this is a service. There's lots of innovations. We've listened to the feedback that we're getting from Office 365 admins. We're making the navigation much more intuitive, right?
Right, and that's why we launched the new Admin Center preview. So with here, we're kind of surfacing it, making more intuitive so that admins can easily access the most common tasks and scenarios that they do daily or weekly. So for example, I needed to reset a password for one of my users. Mm-hmm. All I need to do is navigate over to the user section, click on reset password, type in the user's name. In this case, it's Alex Darrow. Click on Alex Darrow and reset. And that's it. I had never left the home page at all.
You're right on the home page. In the past, you would have had to go back into the user center, click on Alex, select him, then reset password, then type the password. So you've just saved quite a few clicks, right?
Correct, making it much simpler for our users.
So what else have we done?
We've also simplified the way you can add a user and purchase a license right in the same flow. Mm-hmm. For example, imagine I had a new user just joining the company. So I click on Add User. I type in their name. And as you can see, as I scroll down, there's a tooltip that pops up and says, hey, you need to purchase a new subscription. By clicking on Save, not only did I provision a new user, I purchased an Office 365 license as well.
Right, and in the past, you would have had to go back. You'd have tried to provision the user, and then you would have been informed that you're out of licenses. Then you have to go back and purchase licenses, then go back into the user and add that license to the user. So again, I've just saved a ton of clicks just to do that one flow.
Correct. This subtle change makes the whole process of providing tools for your users to be productive much easier. These are just two examples of some of the changes that we've made. We've also added the ability for you to quickly view your monthly bill, as well as edit your payment methods. And this is just the start. This is a preview. There are more enhancements coming.
Great. I know we've done a lot of work in terms of reporting, so why don't you show us what's new there?
Yes. So we've heard from our users the need for greater insights, and this is coming to the Office 365 Admin Center.
All right, let's take a look.
So let me give you a sneak peek at what we're doing. So this is the Office 365 usage dashboard. What this enables you to see at a high level across your tenant is how your users are using Office 365. We show you trend information across a given period of time, as well as key metrics across all the different Office 365 services. For example, if I want to know what type of email activity that my users are doing, I can quickly take a glance at the tile and see, in this example, I have 5,000 emails being sent and received across my tenant. If I want deeper information, I just simply click on the tile, and I'm taken into a detailed user report where I have trend information about the activity across the given period. And if I need user details, I can dive right in and see the individual users, how many emails they sent, read, and received. And what's more, you have the ability now to export all your data, process it in Excel, and do more reports if you need it. And as more services become available, they'll be added to the Office 365 usage dashboard.
And at Ignite, we actually gave an early look, a preview of Power BI, showing some of this data as well.
Right. If you need more advanced analytics, coming soon to Office 365 is the content pack for Power BI. What that enables you to do is get richer insights into how your users are using Office 365 by combining your Office 365 usage data with your organization's user information.
Do you have it running?
Yes. Let me give you a sneak peek.
Okay.
So this is the dashboard that you'll see. This is an example. And what you can do with the Office 365 content pack for Power BI is pivot on attributes such as department, for example. Here I can see a high-level look of how the activity is trending across time. By clicking on the tile, I'm brought into richer insights. I can see how each department is adopting Office 365. What this empowers you to do is to increase adoption by adjusting adoption plans if needed, and maximizing your return on investment.
Yeah, something a lot of people have been asking for. But also, beyond just what's in the browser, we've done a lot of great work on phones and really being able to check on this on the go, right?
Right. With the Office 365 and Mint app, you can manage your users, you can view your service health, check messages on Message Center, as well as contact support.
Okay.
We've continuously innovated on the Office 365 and Mint app. We are constantly bringing new innovations to the app, including push notifications. So now you're able to select the services that you want notifications from. And this is simply done. Click, select the main menu, tap on settings, tapping on notifications, and there you are. You have your suite of services that you can select your push notifications from. And this is important because if you're an exchange admin, you may not want to be notified by SharePoint, service incidents, and more.
Right, right.
Coming soon, you'll have the ability to receive push notifications from Message Center as well. And this is especially important if we need to notify you of an issue that you have to fix on-prem.
So in addition to all the things that you saw here in the browser and the new portal redesign and all the reporting in the app, we've also done a lot of work in terms of PowerShell and automation, right?
That's right. We just recently launched PowerShell.office.com. And what this is a website resource that's great for admins new to PowerShell. It quickly tells you what and why you would use PowerShell and when. It enables you to get started quickly. It gives you the top 20 common scenarios that you would use PowerShell for, as well as sample scripts so that you can quickly get started right away.
That's really great if you're kind of getting into PowerShell or beginning that. But if you're really an advanced user or fancy yourself as a bit more of an advanced PowerShell user, we've also launched in August another project around IT Pro deployment scripting for Office 2016 that I think a lot of people will find very useful. For example, things like being able to copy over GPO settings from the 2013 install. One of the more recent updates, we've also given the ability to create your own configuration XML file or maybe reverse engineer the existing install. And all of that is actually on GitHub. So you can go to the Office blog and find the links to that or go to GitHub and actually just start using this PowerShell script samples. Beyond all of this stuff, where do I get started if I want to learn more about this?
The new Office 365 Admin Center is in preview today, so it will continue to evolve with more and more capability. When it becomes available for your tenant, you simply need to enable it right from the UI. The other thing, download the Office 365 and Mint app. It's invaluable and it's available for iOS, Android, and Windows Phone.
And of course, the PowerShell resources that we just showed you are already public now, both the GitHub project and PowerShell.office.com. You know, all of these great things are coming for admins. And of course, you can stay up to date with everything news in Office 365 on Wednesdays or as news breaks with Microsoft Mechanics. Thank you, everybody, for watching, and goodbye for now.